Hi everyone, my name is Chris Wilk, and I am the product lead for Health Connect.
And I'm Sara Hamilton, an Android developer advocate focused on helping developers build health and fitness experiences on Android.
Today we're going to talk to you about Health Connect by Android. Health Connect is a new platform that helps Android users securely store health and wellness data on their phone, and it gives them a simple way to connect and share this data with their favorite apps. For developers like you, it is a new common API for Android. With user permission, you'll be able to securely access this health and wellness data. In this session, Sara and I will give you an overview of the platform and how it works. Let's get started. On Google Play, there are thousands of apps that help users achieve their personal wellness goals. Whether that be staying more active, sleeping better, or tracking a fertility journey. Now more than ever, people use multiple devices to track and measure their progress. Phones can track steps or even detect snoring during the night. Wearables can monitor heart rate and measure stress. And health at home devices can accurately track your blood pressure. All of these apps and devices generate a lot of interesting data and really valuable data for the user. This data is helpful on its own, letting users answer straightforward questions like, did I meet my activity goals today? How well did I sleep last night? How is my weight trending? This data is powerful when combined, giving users a deeper picture into their health and well-being and actionable insights. Say, based on my vitals, am I ready for a high-intensity workout today, or should I just go for a walk? Does meditation in bed help me fall asleep easily? Is my fitness and nutrition plan working for me? So the first step was to talk to our users to deeply understand what they wanted. And we found that they did see the value in connecting and sharing data between their health and wellness apps. But they found consistently that data is trapped within each app or service that they use. And this is because Android doesn't currently offer a consistent way to share health data between their apps. We thought we could fix this. We found that users wanted to see all of their data in one place, and they want to choose which app they want to see it in. We thought we could help here too. Importantly, we found that users need to stay in control of their privacy and know that their data is secure. So privacy controls have to be at the heart of our solution. We listened to our developer community. Overwhelmingly, we heard that the number of platforms your apps need to integrate with on Android and maintain is really challenging. Each API has a different schema and different API behaviors. This is not only time consuming, but it is actually very costly to your business. We want to solve these problems by creating a universal solution for Android. No matter which devices your users use or which apps they choose to use, it will work for them. We want to create common standards with the help of our developer community. This makes it easier to use the data so that you can bring better insights and experiences to your users. And with a common platform, you will benefit from reaching more users with less work. Our long-term vision is to help you reach 3 billion plus Android users with one integration. And we've been working very hard to bring this to life. Today, we're so excited to introduce you to Health Connect by Android. Health Connect is a common API for storing and sharing health data on Android phones. Developers can read from and write data to an on-device data store. We've standardized the schema and API behavior, making it easy for you to use the data. We've centralized the permissions and the privacy controls, making it clear and simple for your users to manage this data and access to it. We are so happy to announce we're bringing together Fitbit, Google Fit, and Samsung Health under this one united API. We've designed and developed this platform in collaboration with these leading health and wellness apps, and we'll hear more from Sara about those partners in a moment. Out of the box, Health Connect supports more than 50 data types across 6 categories. So that's activity, including exercises, sleep, nutrition, cycle tracking, body measurements, and of course your vitals. Things like your heart rate and your blood pressure. So with user permission, apps can write data into Health Connect as well as read it back out. Health Connect is designed to give users full control over their privacy. Users can easily see what the app is requesting access to, toggle access on and off at any time, delete data they don't want anymore, and manage the priority of those data sources. So our toolkit for building health and wellness apps on Android is expanding and ever evolving. Health Services provides an access to real-time sensor data on Wear OS in a power-efficient way. We introduced this last year, and it's now in beta. Check out the Wear OS technical session for this year's updates. Health Connect allows access to health and wellness data stored on your phone. Web APIs for both Fitbit and Google Fit allow access to health and wellness data stored in the cloud, which is associated with the user's Google or Fitbit account. Both Health Services and Health Connect have streamlined our API offering on Android. So Health Connect becomes the new way for Android apps to sync data with Google Fit on device. So this means that the existing Google Fit Android APIs will be deprecated. We will continue to invest in the web APIs that we've already mentioned. We know this migration will take some time, and that's why developers using Google Fit Android APIs today should visit the documentation for guidance on what to do. Health Connect is available to developers today. The Alpha SDK is available from Android Jetpack. We have published the privacy and security policy online, and the app is available from Google Play. So sign up for the open beta. So when will users see the benefit? So Health Connect will be available to users this fall. This is when the Health Connect app will be released to everybody and when the first partner integrations will go live. Sara is going to show you how it all works now.
So now I'll talk about how you can use Health Connect in your own Android app. I'll discuss a hypothetical reproductive health app as an example. The app lets users share data about their menstrual cycles with their favorite health apps and reads in nutrition and activity data to provide better insights to their users. I'll review the high-level architecture of how an app like this would use Health Connect, and then I'll dive into some code examples. So Health Connect provides an SDK that apps can use to integrate with the API. It also provides an app for users, which is available via Play Store and beta and will come pre-installed on some Android devices later this year. If the user hasn't installed Health Connect yet, don't worry. When you call the Health Connect SDK, the user will be brought through a download flow to install the app. So first, the app requests permissions from the users. After getting permissions, the app can write in data to Health Connect storage on device. And then other apps that the user has granted permission to will also be writing to Health Connect. Then the app can read back the data the user is interested in. In this reproductive health example, the app reads in nutrition data and activity data. Before moving into details, I wanted to highlight a helpful component of the developer toolkit, health services. Developers can use the Health Services API to collect real-time sensor data from Wear OS in a power-efficient way. Once collected, you can use Health Connect to store and share the data with other apps. Check out our documentation for more info on how you can use both Health Services and Health Connect together. So, now I'll break down the example above and show how to actually build this. So, let's start with requesting permissions. Privacy is central to Health Connect. An app must get user approval for fine-grained permissions for each individual data type it wants to read or write. Adding any additional data types requires requesting that specific permission from the user. So a user will see a permission request screen in the Health Connect UI where they can toggle access for different data types on or off. The UI also displays a list of existing permission settings and the apps that are connected. A user can remove a specific data type permission or an app's permission from this UI at any time. As a note, these permission screens are the primary UI for Health Connect. This is because we want users to have a single place to manage their data privacy, and we want users to view the data and insights primarily in their favorite health and fitness apps. With just a few lines of code, an app can request the fine-grained read and write permissions. This snippet will launch the UI screen that I just discussed. So first, build a set of permissions the app is interested in. In this example, we want to write menstrual cycle data and read nutrition and activity data. So as you can see, we need a line for every single type. Then, launch the permissions request and check the result. So once the user has granted the app permissions, the app can write data. Health Connect supports over 50 common data types. These data types are specifiers for common types of health and fitness data and their formats. So here are a few examples of data types related to reproductive health and to activity, just to give you an idea of what these data types look like. For activity data, the data can be grouped into activity sessions to track all the metrics associated to one workout together. When you're writing, the data can be formatted in a few different ways. Our goal was for these formats to give you the flexibility to read and write the data you need while still maintaining a consistent format. Sample data is an instantaneous measurement, like meals, weight, or resting heart rate at a given moment. Interval data is a measurement that has a start time and an end time. So this could be the number of calories burned from the start to the end of a workout. Series data is suited for high-frequency sensor data, like continuous heart rate samples during an activity. This is how to write data. So compose a list of records, which in this case is a single menstruation entry, but this could also be a longer list of different types. And after getting permissions, then you can write the data to Health Connect storage on device, which you can see here. So now I'll show you how to read data. You can read back a single data entry using the unique ID for that piece of data, or you can read back all the records from a given time frame. Health Connect also provides aggregated data. There are a few different types of aggregations. Statistical provides the average, minimum, or maximum values in a set, like the maximum heart rate during a workout. Cumulative provides the sum of values over a given time range, like the total step count in a day. Count just provides a simple count of the number of data entries, like number of workouts in a week. And duration provides the total duration of one type of data values, like the time spent sleeping this week. Health Connect will dedupe data for you across multiple sources and return a single record. Users can choose the merging priority within the Health Connect UI if there are two or more data points of the same type within the same period. So here's how you can read back the user's total steps stored in Health Connect, which could be recorded by any of the user's favorite fitness apps that they've granted permissions to. So you choose a set of metrics you'd like to retrieve, so steps, the start and end time, and an optional data origin filter. Here, I passed an empty list as I don't want to filter, but you could optionally add a subset of apps. Then, request the metrics from Health Connect. So in summary, with the simple snippets I showed, the app now enables the user to share their menstrual cycle data with their favorite health and fitness apps, and the app can allow the user to pull in activity data from their favorite fitness trackers, all while giving a user full control over exactly what data is stored and shared. Now that I've shared a bit about how to develop using the Health Connect API, I'll explain how some real developers have been using it. I'd like to introduce you to some of the partners we've been working with in our early access program. I'll deep dive into two of these partners' integrations to show you how they're using Health Connect. So we're really excited to partner with Withings, whose award-winning health ecosystem of connected devices and apps is designed to improve daily well-being and long-term health. Withings has an ecosystem of connected health devices. For example, they have a smart blood pressure monitor that can provide medically accurate blood pressure and heart rate readings, and a smart thermometer that yields medical-grade results. Through their HealthMate app's integration with Health Connect, users can now share the Withings data throughout the ecosystem. Once Health Connect is activated in Withings HealthMate application, users choose the health data they want to share. Health Connect brings together Withings data and external data from other applications on the phone so that users keep track of their activity and health data as a whole, enjoying all the benefits of HealthMate application monitoring. HealthMate processes all this data to solve conflicts and avoid duplicates or inconsistencies. And their data visualization highlights each data source to better identify the origin. Withings are reading and writing a rich set of data types in this integration, including activities and workouts, VO2 max, sleep, oxygen saturation, and muscle and fat mass. We've gotten some really positive feedback from the Withings team on their integration, and I wanted to share a quote from their product owner, who said, "At Withings, we believe that we can be healthier together. We are committed to helping users share and use their health data, whether it's with health reports for healthcare professionals or sports performance with their friends. Health Platform is a powerful tool for sharing data while remaining secure, simple, and centralized." As a second example, we are partnering with MyFitnessPal, MyFitnessPal is the number one nutrition and food tracking app in the world, helping nearly 1 million members reach their nutrition and fitness goals every year. Their database of over 14 million foods allows users to get a complete picture of their nutrition. MyFitnessPal users want a comprehensive picture of their health and wellness activities, but this data can exist across many different health and fitness apps. With Health Connect, MyFitnessPal users can connect data from all their favorite health and fitness apps in one place. Here's how it works. MyFitnessPal writes their nutrition data into Health Connect, bringing the info from their full database of foods. So all the micro and macronutrients associated with a food will be stored in Health Connect. And then MyFitnessPal reads in activity data from Health Connect, making it easy for users to see all their workouts in one place with just a single data connection. This enables users to see an accurate view of their health, including the calories they've taken in and burned, and their activity, all within the MyFitnessPal app. It has been great working with the MyFitnessPal team on this. I wanted to share a quote from their CEO, who said, "MyFitnessPal is thrilled to be a premier partner of Health Connect, bringing comprehensive global nutrition data to our Android members and allowing them to have a holistic picture of and insights into their health and wellness." Those are just two of our partners, but we've been working with a variety of others who are leaders in their verticals as well. We're really looking forward to the launches of these integrations, which are coming soon. And now, back to you, Chris.
Okay, to recap, Health Connect is available to developers today. So go get the SDK from Android Jetpack, review the privacy and security policy, and for the app, sign up for the open beta via Google Play. We would love for you to be part of our launch with the users this fall, alongside our early access partners, and of course, Fitbit, Google Fit, and Samsung Health. Please visit developer.android.com/healthconnect for the SDK, documentation, code samples, and links to the privacy and security policy. That's the end of our session. Today, with Health Connect, we believe we can help users achieve their health and wellness goals while keeping them in control of their privacy and making sure that their data is safe and secure. Thank you all for listening.